That for this video for Vloggerdome. So I'm going to attempt to explain why life fails, and why simply people shouldn't think it's a good idea to keep perpetuating it. Yes, it's going to be a complaint video, complaining about the nature of existence. Yeah, but backing it up with an argument, try explaining why, what you think about your life and its magnificence. Is just crap in your head, and it doesn't have any constituent in reality. And I'm gonna get this guy to help. Hey, I said to help. Hey, I'm saying all kinds of stuff. Yeah, wait till you're asked to speak, right? That's how guests should behave. Anyway, so yeah, let's begin with the argument. So now there's a simple argument, the argument from imposition. Alright, now, just simply stated, you don't get consent when you force people to exist. You're basically obliging them to think your amusement park is the amusement park, and they're going to just love it at Dolly World or whatever you think life is doing. So when you have a kid, or you let people have kids, you're basically letting them invest somebody else's welfare in their notions of a good time. And we know that there's huge risk to this amusement park. Just obscene risks. And, it's a hell of a thing to do. One hell of a thing to do, creating life. Procreation. Whoa, really? And if you don't have a good reason, if your reason is, I want to, well, that's pretty bogus. So, what's the counter-argument, buddy? I'm doing this, devil's advocate thing, right? That's a tough argument, and really... I don't know what can I say. It's nature. Nature says I can. It gave me a willy full of juice to do it. You know, lots and lots of babies I could make. So why shouldn't I just make them? Well, I thought you could do a little better than that. Not to really, you know, that's vacuous is what it is. The resort to nature says so is just, you know, it's not an argument. You have to do a little better than that. A little something more. Alright, let's see. Okay, so nature, it's got to be related to nature, right? Because it's the universe, and that's the universe is nature. The universe is mechanical things. The mechanical things do this thing. They made these things that do this stuff, and we think and do all important thinking thing. And so even though it is kind of risky and sloppy and messy, well, it should be, because look at all that's been invested 4 billion years to make it, so why not keep it? Well, sort of. Yeah, alright. So now that's the argument from traditional behavior, or the argument from it was already there, I didn't make the mess, I'm just keep making more mess. I mean, those are kind of bogus arguments also. You know, you gotta deal with the bottom line, okay? It's a hell of a thing to do. And if you don't have a good reason, you know, not a selfish reason, but some sort of theoretical principle that's being satisfied, some idea of accomplishment, it just really isn't fair, fundamentally. It just fails the fairness test, and that's the whole point of having intelligence, is to figure out what's fair. Oh, man. Now I gotta argue against fairness? Right, okay, it's unfair. People should, look, I agree. People should have a reason. I don't know, what can I say? They probably should have a better reason than I want to. I didn't even want to, which, you know, makes it easy for me. But, I mean, obviously, they should get it. They should get how important it is and just be able to do the right thing and not have kids. So, yeah, I mean, there is no real counter-argument. You can't look into the universe and say, okay, there's the reason people need to exist because it puts a smiley face on the moon. Yeah, it doesn't do any of that. So it is kind of, you're right. Okay, let's move on to, what's your next argument? Because I can really make a mess out of your next argument, that's for sure. All right, well, the next argument is the argument from futility. Yeah, that's right, we need an exit strategy, that's the word. See, the whole thing's going to be, the universe is going to annihilate us. It's just a fact. It's going to make a huge mess out of the Earth eventually. And it's going to do it probably in some incremental way. You know, we'll get hit with an asteroid or some other kind of thing, and life will get horrible, or we'll nuke each other, or bacterial something or other, or global whatever, flooding, global, you know, just global octopuses. It'll be something horrible. And you're just sentencing the last generation, the last generations, to go through some horrible dying process as the Earth and the biosphere die before the whole thing gets irradiated by the sun eventually when it crashes into the other galaxies and all this other crap. It's going to happen inevitably anyway. So the whole thing, this complexity, will, by flaws of physics, be annihilated. So there'll be, it's just, you're just perpetuating for what reason? We know what it is. We played the game. We said, okay, it was interesting why we were dumb. But it's horribly brutal, you know, horribly unfair intrinsically. No consent agreements, like I said, you know, no, it's just obnoxious on so many levels. Let's just gracefully slide out of here with our dignity and our intelligence respected. Oh, man. Yeah, okay, it's hard to disagree with that one, too, but, no, we should stay right to the end, because there could be something really, really, really cool that we don't understand, like, something really cool that we don't understand yet. Something like, magic stuff, super colossal Higgs boson gold. Higgs boson gold? We could make gold in Higgs bosons? Yeah, you really annihilated this argument. Man, you were failing all over the place. Yeah, what can I say? That's not going to work either. You got to do better than that. Yeah, I mean, you know, it's just logical. I mean, obviously human beings don't like being logical because we see it in our own lives. People don't prepare for the dying process, then they end up dying really sloppily. And they just squander their sacred fortune on, you know, the most miserable part of their life. They spend the most money on the most miserable part of their life, ironically. I mean, it's just idiotic. And apparently the human race still isn't smart enough to say, wait a minute, that doesn't sound like a good idea. Yeah, that's really dumb. You don't invest in yourself when you're a corpse. You invest in yourself when you have some potential. Aha! You said we had potential, so I'll catch you on that. So what's the potential? I have no clue what it freaking could be. I was just using it as a word to say that in a life you have more potential, let's just say. You have less potential. Okay? You have more negative, you have less negative potential, you know, in the beginning of your life than you do at the end of your life. At the end of your life you have nothing but negative potentialities. The risk equation becomes preposterously obnoxious, where you're just likely to torture yourself for no good reason whatsoever. And that's really dumb. So anyway, moving on to the next argument. The argument from not cost-effective. Yeah, most people, animals live mediocrity and die badly. Yeah, that's a good argument. Also, they're all good arguments. But really, the cost-effective argument is so easy to understand. You can see it in your own existence that you put the bad stuff in this little special place in the basement, and you keep the good stuff on the mantle, right, you know, over there, like the wild turkey or something. And yeah, you just don't, you psychologically don't look at life the right, you know, fairly, your own existence. And if you had to do it ahead of time, like you knew exactly what was going to happen, you had the pile of all the bad stuff on one side and the pile of all the good stuff on the other side, and you knew, you know, just how thin the good stuff would be, just how short a period of time it would really last before, you know, it all turned to shit. You know, and you had these horrible things on the other side. You had to trade the two, you know, by some equitable exchange. You had to buy your way out of the negative things by giving up the positive things. Yeah, you'd run out of positive pretty quickly and be just stuck with a bunch of negatives that you can't buy your way out of. And you'd do it, you'd be glad to do it to avoid those negatives. That's how bad the negatives can be. Oh, I don't know about that. So I'll make the argument from, but some people don't have lives like that. They don't really experience the real hard shit, and so it's really easy for them just to say, hey, this life thing ain't so tough. I play a little baseball. I go around and flirt around at the bar, and I go to bed, and then I wake up the next day and do the same thing, and blah, 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 blah. So, it ain't so bad. Yeah, but they can understand that it is bad if they had some horrible disease or some chronic pain illness or some other kind of thing. Or they could certainly understand if they see animals getting, road killed, and they can understand that they'd really hate to be invested in a life and just have it, have your spine broken and you die on the side of a road. They could figure out that, I really don't want to do that shit. Just the way some people die, being crushed by your own house in a flood or something. I would pay a lot not to have that day. no thank you. Look, when you're grown up and you put things in perspective, obviously you can say, all this ambition stuff is kind of made out of nothing, and all this ego and vanity stuff is sort of made out of nothing. And so, you do sort of live for a bunch of ingrandized notions and delusions. True. Yeah, so thank you. You just made my argument. I know, this is really difficult because I can't even be dumb enough to make the argument for life, because life really is just so many ways. It's so insidiously turdy. But anyway, we'll move on. Go to the next. It's over there. Wherever it is. Go to the words. Alright. No need serve beyond that we create. Replication for the sake of replication. Surviving for the sake of surviving. That's a tough one too. You go first. Alright, the idea of do humans need to exist? You can ask the question, how do you answer it? I answer because I think they should. I want them to. that's not a good enough answer. You gotta do a lot better than that. And I often use this analogy that you don't think the universe is horribly deprivated because there isn't tentacle people on Mars, or there isn't whatever crystal people on Venus, and whatever round lumpy people on Mercury. You don't think of the universe needing the existence of all these bizarre little whatever drama whore beings going around trying to figure out who they can stick their tentacle in, or their big giant crystalline, or their blobby, and go, that felt good. You just don't. You don't think it's important enough to have the other guys. So it pretty much should reveal to you that you're probably just one of the other guys, too. You're not so special. Your kind isn't so magnificent. Because you can't find it in yourself to imagine an alien better than yourself. you can't do that. It is kind of the joke, isn't it? You sort of got me on that one, because there's all this ego and vain stuff. It's a fight, and you're just going to fight whether it's a good reason or not. People are just like, I'm not going to quit first. They're just doing this silly ego thing, like I have this insatiable itch and I'm just going to keep forcing everybody to scratch it forever. Ugh. You're starting to make my arguments for me. Could you be a little more challenging? Come on, you can come up with a good reason. All right. Well, I have thought about aliens. I like Star Wars and stuff, and I thought most of the alien people were kind of creepy. But, some of them maybe are cool. Spock, like in Star Trek, Spock, Vulcan. I might be cool to be a Vulcan. I wouldn't be that cool because they were really repressed. They were repressed all over the place. All these rules. Don't have a feeling. What am I alive for again, you fucking idiots? Don't have a feeling. Fuck you. So that's just their lack of imagination. I'm sure we could come up with some kind of alien that would just be super cool, like orgy aliens or something, and that would be good. Yeah, but it's still made up of a notion in your head that it needs to exist. You're not explaining how the universe itself would say, thank you very much for making those super cool things. They are just so super cool, and now the universe is so much cooler. There's just no way to improve the universe, because the universe doesn't need anything. We make needs. Needs don't exist until we make them. That's another tough one, because, boy, that's true, isn't it? We just create this shit. We make the problem, and then we say, oh, look, we solved a little bit of it. Yeah, It really is bullshit. We are firemen who start fires. I mean, we're just, you know, self-fulfilling glory hunters. Oof, humans suck. Yeah, well, that's what I'm trying to convince you of. Anyway, so these are just words, but fail safe and risk averse. This is an interesting concept. Whoops, it's me talking. Interesting concepts. You know, the idea of fail safe seems really good. Like, you'd always want to go there if you could. Like, every bad thing, you'd want to make it just fail safe. Like, nothing go wrong here. We're protected against disaster. And you really can't do that with life. Because it's the nature of it. The nature of it is you have to go down to go up. And that's the whole game, right? You have to make the mess before you can clean up the mess. And the same goes for our psychology. You have to create the deprivation. You have to create the appreciation out of some sort of hard-earned character-building kind of thing. The beautiful music won't mean anything if you don't know what the pain is, that it's easing. And that's the catch to all this stuff. And so it'd be nice if you can come up with some other way to do the fail-safe thing without doing it at all. But that's, you know, the fail is safe is just don't turn the switch on. If the switch is on, turn it off. That's the safe thing to do. If the oil burner in the basement's rumbling and bumbling and spitting, then yeah, you turn the switch off. Well, it's another good argument. I'm not against turning switches off, but yeah. I don't know, what can I say? I mean, people, we want the switch on because the universe is better with the lights on. But that's a silly metaphor because it's not as safe as lights being on. You know, there is this hard scream. I mean, every time you turn the lights on, you heard a scream. Yeah. Would that say to you something like, well, maybe I won't turn the lights on as often? Because I hear that scream, and I don't know where it's coming from, and I don't know what it represents. But that's sort of like life. When you're procreating, you should hear a little scream. Say, whoa, don't do that again. Because, man, that is messy stuff. There's a scream tied to this. Yeah. So anyway, we won't bother with risk aversion, will we? I suppose not, because it just seems like an obvious concept that you're, especially when the risk is imposed on somebody else, you know, especially when you're putting the faulty device in somebody else's hand. Like, you know, the skateboard has bad wheel design or something. You're not gonna let your kid ride it. Maybe you'll fuck around with it, but you're not gonna let your kid on it, right? Come on. Well, you got me there too. I ain't gonna defend fucking with kids like that. Fucking with kids. Well, you know what I mean. I mean, it's just not okay, not right. All right, moving on to the next thing, please. Joy doesn't undo sorrow. Desire perverts judgment. Well, those are really good ones. Yeah, let's hear what you got to say. Just as a practical matter, if I'm happy and somebody else in the room is miserable, they got a migraine headache or whatever, I can't fix it with my happiness. My happiness doesn't make it all okay. It just doesn't. You can't undo somebody else's pain with your happiness. It's the same thing in your life. Your happy moments don't really undo the bad moments. And it's only because of desire that the whole balance gets broken. You'd be able to see the truth really easy if you weren't driven by, I need. I got to make one more video. I gotta sew one more little stitch. We're just never done because we think there's more to accomplish and more to build on our little glory pedestal that we're building for ourselves. And we can make it a brick higher and a brick higher, and I can make my statue higher than everybody else's in the dead yard. Yes, yeah, that's really dumb. You're right there. Yeah, anyway, but it is kind of cool, though. Statues, I could be pointing down from my very high pedestal that all the rest of the people saying, you suck. And that might be worth living for. Maybe. But, I mean, I do concede the point. We're just driven by stupid, idiotic ego crap, you know. I'm not done yet. What do you mean you're not done yet? You'll never be done. Because there's always another glass of water to drink. Because you're going to get thirsty again. And that's the game. and you just realize that you're being gamed by a molecule. It's a DNA molecule, and it's gaming you. Well, now you're being aggressively on my side, which is really counterproductive, probably. Well, it is just, I mean, really, what's the devil advocate's argument, okay? The truth is that it's almost insulting to people's misery to say your happiness makes it all okay. The fact that little happy people are running around makes it okay, that all the people dying horribly and watching their kids get squished right before their eyes and all that shit. Oh, it's all acceptable and okay because I went bowling last night and scored 113. Which would be a really lousy score, but yes, that's apparently good enough for most people. if they don't dent the sidewalk, walk into the store, they feel like, it was a good day. Silly fuckers. Anyway, the good of existence has no evidence in reality. Well, I did sort of touch upon that before. Yeah, that one is a little bit redundant, but it's true, right? Yeah, the good of existence has no evidence in reality. It's just a perceived thing. Yeah, that's actually right in the text, see? Just a perceived notion projection of value. So we just make it up, basically, and say, okay, I think it needs to exist because it scares me if it doesn't. It gives me a unsettled, willy kind of feeling. Yeah, exactly. Has nothing to do with rationality. Just has to do with affection. It's like, I hate to say it, but say it quietly. It's like stuffed animals, right? You can have like a little stuffed animal, and you'd be like, I can't throw that thing out. because I've given it a personality, and it's like, no, it's my friend. I mean, I know it's just a stuffed animal. I know it's a fake piece of crap. But, we do that. We anthropomorphize, and we get attached to things, like a building or something even. We could say, don't tear down the great old blah, 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 because it's the great old blah, blah, blah. And that's all we're doing with life here. We're giving it the benefit of the doubt because it's old and it's been around a long time. And so we just say, it's precious, it's precious, it's precious, it's precious. But, yeah, there's no evidence of it being precious. It's just some old stupid trinket thing. It's just a piece of plastic with a funny face on it or whatever. And we're attached to it. And instead of admitting the psychology that owns us, smart people just keep pretending the psychology is the philosophy. Ooh, that's a whole nother subject, a whole nother video. But, yeah, that's going on all over the place. People just talk psychology. And call it philosophy. It's just disgusting. So anyway, I think we've done enough to initiate this subject. 20-some kind of minutes. I don't know, 3 or 4. Yeah, that's a lot of minutes. Anyway, sorry about that. But yeah, since it's just hard to do in some sort of direct way, you have to kind of just work your way into it. So we're just going to slide our way into it and see if we can get a counter argument that has something to do with the points made here. Yeah, that's the game. Alright, so till the next time, and such, and so forth and whatnot. Procreation bad. Stopping the procreation is good. Simple.